All right, hi guys. I am going to try to make this happen. I thought I recorded it last night during one of Craig and I's overnight camp outs in our living room, but I've been trying to edit all day and it's not working, so I guess I deleted everything by accident or I never recorded in the first place. So I have had a very productive couple of days and I just wanted to share some, and because I want to talk more about it later. Sorry, I'm down here. I've got to get a proper holder for my iPad, but I just want to try it this way. So it's propped up right now. Oops, sorry. So I'm going to push this back a bit further. It's going to be as quick as I can because I'm way behind. So this is, I do have videos about this way back when I first tried buying this stuff. Anybody want to know what it's called? I'm just going to give you some pictures. A little bit of video so you can see what it is, and then you're gonna see what happens when I do something with it. So right now you're gonna guess, and I'm gonna give a couple clues. There's a special day coming up tomorrow for all of our beloved mothers. So this is something, this is a component, or starting to be a component, and obviously I'm way behind because my mom's coming tomorrow. Yeah, so this is something that I got to work on yesterday. While I, of course, have been listening to a particular trial that's been broadcast everywhere. But then, something even more exciting. I was inspired recently by somebody named Christy Rice. And how was I inspired, you ask? Well, she is a watercolor artist. And I've only watched a few of her tutorials, but she is extremely inspirational and a really good tutor. And all that banging is me trying to get my visuals to show you. Just to show you. I'm going to show more when Craig and I actually do this. But I actually, if you've been following, last night's video was way better because I had more time and I was more into the moment. But, okay, here's like a swatching page. Anyway, I was watching her, and I dabbled in watercolor very briefly once when I took a class with my dad. Watercolor is a water-soluble paint, which is totally different to what Craig and I work with, which is oil. Craig used to work in watercolor way back when he first started, but then he married me and started using my leftover paint, which was acrylic. So these are special kits that I learned about from watching Christy Rice. And she has a great channel on the YouTube, as I try to say to be funny, but probably not that funny. And these are special tins, and inside them, they're called this particular size is called half pan watercolors. So they hold these little rectangular cubes or little receptacles for the watercolor paint. And the cool thing is with watercolor, doing it this way is you can go outside and paint and you don't have to worry. Well, acrylic for me is impossible. Once I tried painting outside with my acrylic and it dries so fast, I just couldn't do it. So after listening to Christy, and it's not just about doing watercolor, I just found listening to her very, very inspirational. She's very motivating. She's very lovely to listen to. She's very good at details and tips, and she's taught thousands of people. She's not very old, so she has been, I don't think it was just through the internet, she's taught thousands because she shows footage of like actual classes. So what I did was I spent the latter half of the day setting up a palette for Craig and I, because I dictated declared to Craig, hey Craig, guess what we're going to do? We are going to get into watercolor, and we're going to follow, not just Christy's tutorials, but what other? There's lots of great tutorials on YouTube, but I set up, this is my palette. I'm sorry, I can't lift it up better. You can see mine's probably a little more floral-like, and the thing is with the watercolor is I squirted them out of, I bought a few boxes of just 5 mil tubes of acrylic paint. This is a particular brand from Amazon called Paul Rubens, and Very good packaging. These are the best. I'm into packaging. And these are the sturdiest boxes I've ever seen. Don't know if they're great quality, but so far just from filling up these little receptacles, the little half pans, I can tell from the mess I made, there's quite a lot of pigment. And you can see on my fingers, I've got pigment. So yeah, so I squirted for each tube. I got a set that's supposed to hold. I tried to find the most inexpensive metal paint palette that I could find. And I was able to get, so far, basically 1 5-mil tube will do two of those little receptacles with a tiny bit, like a little bit left over. So because Craig is more into landscapes, I put his as more like his. Here, just getting too many ideas in my head, so my brain gets distracted. So here's Craig's, and this, no, sorry, this one's mine that I just showed you. Way to go, Nina. They look the same. They are the same actual identical pens, because I was trying to find something fairly inexpensive, because I can get very impulsive, and then I'm like, I don't want to spend a lot of money until I know for sure that this might work. And based on Christy's advice, she actually sells her own brush sets, but I couldn't really afford that, so something she calls a dagger brush. And this is, I believe this is a half-inch one. She uses her, and I can't wait to show you. Well, just check out her channel to see how she uses a special brush. This type of tip I've never seen before. But as you watch her, you can say, oh, I really need that brush type, because it can do some really cool things. So like I said, my palette is more florally, and the one I made for Craig, I was gonna get him to do his own, but he's been so busy doing everything else, I thought I'd do it for him. So then I left, there's a bunch of blank ones, because like I said, he's not really florally, he's more landscapey. So it's hard to tell what the colors are, so you have to, Craig, who does have experience working in watercolor color, mind you, he hasn't worked in it really since he married me 20 years ago, because he started using the acrylic. He said, you just take a little dab with some water, and it'll show up, like, obviously on the paper, because it's so condensed, you can't see. So fill up these, this is what I was doing for, it took a long time to do this, so, yeah, but it was fun. So they opened up these new paint sets and just started squirting the tubes into each receptacle. And then it dries. That's the goal. They're still not dry. It'll take a while. And here, like, I hardly have any left. But the box is really good quality. So this is one set. And then there was another set that I thought was different, but in the end, it turns out it was pretty much the same, but just less paint. So, and this one I got, this is the same brand. I don't know why I thought it would be a decent brand, but probably this was about maybe $26 Canadian roughly. But yeah, and this is a vivid, like, neon fluorescent color that Craig wouldn't really be into. So the only one I put on his was fluorescent yellow, because Christy Rice mentioned the need for fluorescent yellow. And I'm sure we will learn why it's beneficial to watercolor when we start following her lessons. And so those are paint palettes that you make yourself, and you can select what you want. Then this is one I covered a while ago in my channel. This is Artistro, and I love it because it's Tiffany blue. And if you look at our house, if you've seen any footage, you know I like aqua blue. So for this one, this is a 48. So these must be like quarter pan size, but these aren't interchangeable. You can't take these out and stuff like that. But these are actually, Artistro's a pretty good brand. I've used the paint pens that are in acrylic and things like that. And this is a watercolor set. I obviously didn't get very far. I was just excited to see a really fancy container. Yes, I can be lured in by packaging. So yeah, and this actually came with, which I really thought was cool, the watercolor brush that fills up with water. And so if you don't have a water receptacle, with watercolor, you always want to have like fresh, clean water, because as you'll discover, using the surface of the paper is where you get your white. And I'm going to talk about it more in the future as we learn about what paper weight means and why you need to work with anything that's a wet medium like watercolor. It should be a rag paper or actually made out of cotton, not a tree. But you can use multimedia pads, which is what we're going to be working with. Heavyweight means just like the density and thickness of the paper. And then she uses a spray bottle to spray the palette, so you're going to reconstitute the paint. The beauty of watercolor is I gave up years and years ago after I took a course with my dad. As much fun as it was, I was thrilled to be able to take a course with my dad. But I just got frustrated because you can't rework mistakes. Not like you can acrylic. Acrylic, you work on a canvas, paper, board, whatever, even clothing. You can paint on clothing with acrylic, and it's not water soluble. So it's permanent, and then you can paint over it or whatever. But with watercolor, you can't. It's very, it's sort of the opposite to me. You work from the light to dark. So, and if you use a spray bottle to keep the acrylic paint saturated so it doesn't dry out, because if it dries out, you'll have a skin on it and you won't be able to use that ever again. It'll dry right up. So watercolor, I'm excited to learn to embrace it for the first time in my life, really. Even though I did try it that little time before, because I can do it with Craig, who has experience, because when he first learned how to paint, that's what he was using was watercolor. And, you know, to learn from his wisdom. And Christy Rice. And, of course, any other artists out there. So I hope you're inspired to try, and that you're a little bit excited, maybe, if you're interested in learning anything about painting, watercoloring, creating, anything like that on Heartfully Creating. That's what we're here about. The world will be colliding. The walking way we're rated is about our life. And as well, painting and being artists, that's part of our life too. So I'm going to be combining not just Heartfully Creating, but also Walking Way Overrated, because it's Craig and I. And then I'm just going to be interjecting with videos. And then soon, because tomorrow I'm going to work on this. It is called needle felting, I'll tell you that much. But I'll show you when I'm done, or I might even show a little bit of how to do it if I get that. I have to try to set up this camera situation, or iPad actually situation, better, because I just feel like it's not really giving a good view. And oops, sorry, let me just turn for a second so I can see you. So oops. So thank you very much for stopping by, and I hope you're inspired to create and try. And happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. And I look forward to sharing what Craig and I are going to be playing around with as we learn more about watercolor, or as Craig teaches me, basically, where I've been able to help him with acrylic for the last 20 years. So yeah, so cool. So have a great night, everyone, and happy creating.